Howdy. I know I didn't tell anybody that I was going to be doing this, and I've got Mr. Jason Brown already on the screen with me. And we were planning on doing this at 9, and then it got moved and changed because I have kids that are adults that I had to feed. And so I went to town, got groceries, and came home and made my youngest son chicken tenders, you know, because poor little feller can't do that at his place. Anyway,
I'll tell you what, those waffles are good.
Oh, heck yeah. Heck yep. Yeah. Hey, I want to talk to you tonight about, you know, a hot dog cart. We all know what a hot dog cart is, but is it just a hot dog cart? And if you're in Vendors United with us, you know it ain't. You know for a fact it ain't. It's a mini mobile kitchen.
That's one of the things that upsets me when these guys say, oh, I only have a hot dog cart.
Only. You know, and I had that same misconception in the beginning. But, you know, Diz said this so well. You and Diz on Monday night's Mastermind. And y'all were talking about him competing, basically, not intentionally competing, but there was a lot of food trucks out, and you were out with your food truck.
Yeah.
And here's Diz with his big dog cart.
Yeah. But he put all the things he's learned in VU. I mean, he's one of the people that actually took the advice and acted on it.
Right.
You know, and added the candy shelf, added the table, added the tent. He listened when we talked about, you know, his work triangle, so you're not wasting time, because whether you're in a truck, a trailer, or you're serving from a cart, killing the line as fast as you can without putting across sloppy food on the pass is key.
Right.
And Diz did it. I mean, he's done several events. I mean, the one we filmed, the big bonfire with the radio station, there was 22 trucks there. He was the only cart. And again, he was within, I think, $100 of me.
Right.
And that was him and Mrs. Diz under the tent.
Yeah. Now, did you hear that? Here's these food trucks out there, and some of them worth $250,000.
Oh, yeah.
And then, like yours. And then you have Diz with his big dog cart, whole business and everything, $5,000 at the most, stock and all. And then he goes out there and makes $100 less than you.
Oh yeah. And I mean, you've seen the truck. I mean, well, not business truck, but I mean, you've seen the shelves with all the candy and all the different sodas, the Mexican Coke bottles. I mean, all kinds of chips, candy, power bars. I mean, you've seen it. I mean, my menu that night was like 16 items and like 8 sides.
Right.
You know, and Diz was banging out like some exotic sausage, kielbasa. I think he did some burgers that night. He did cotton candy, hot chocolate, you know, soda, water, chips, some candy, that kind of stuff. And I mean, again, I had 4 or 5 people in the truck that night. It was him and his wife.
Yeah.
And a big dog.
And a big dog cart, right. And man, if you're wondering what a big dog cart is, go to hotdogcartstore.com and look at it. Don't just search big dog, because there's a couple people that have knocked me off. Anyway, the reason we're here is talk about, is it just a hot dog cart? And that's why we brought up Diz and Diz's dogs. And Diz and Mrs. Diz are total badasses and just kill it. And they did that because they went and took private lessons with Jason. They did consults with Jason, and they changed everything. But we're going to talk about our misconception with a hot dog cart, because you think of it is, why do we call it a hot dog cart to begin with? Why? Because all 50 states allow it. The thing is, though, all 50 states allow you to cater with that sucker. All 50 states allow you to do events with it. Well, guess what happens at events? Many events, rules are off the table. You can do whatever you want. You want to do walking tacos? You want to do fried shrimp? I've done fried shrimp, fried scallops, fried oysters right from my cart. I did a boil, a low country boil.
Low country boil.
A big dog cart.
Oh, yeah.
And so, So you have to think about that. And if you look at what vendors are doing, especially in Vendors United, we share, a lot of us share what we're doing, and we may not share the amounts, but some of them do share the amounts with us. But many vendors in there are part-time. They COVID stretched them out, and they ended up coming to do the looking for something else. And they ended up finding something else and going, okay, well, I can't really be on a street location all the time. So they're at a hospital 2 days a week because the cafeteria is closed due to COVID. And the hospital's paying them $16,000 every 2 weeks. I mean, we've got vendors in there doing that. So you go, okay, so where do I need to be, and what opportunities does a cart present? Jason, do you care to run through some of the other than street food? Because we all know that, sure, that a hot dog cart can be on the street.
Yep.
But what else can you do with it?
Well, I mean, let's go back to the street for a second, because, you know, one of my pet peeves is when we're talking to people on the show and they say, oh, I only have a hot dog cart. That drives me freaking nuts, okay? Because it's still a mobile catering or a mobile food unit, okay? Just because years ago it was the hot dog cart. Hold on, let me get in the camera line there. There we go. The hot dog cart. It's changed, okay? The menus have morphed, okay? There's a guy in Philly on a big dog, Kung Fu Hoagies, doing vegan and raw hoagies off a cart. There's a guy up in New England doing loaded baked potatoes and sweet potatoes. He's doing those sweet potatoes and baked potatoes that are like a football. And then he's got all kinds of toppings for them. You know, there's guys doing soup, lobster rolls, meatball parm, taco burrito menus off of there. There's a guy doing sushi off of it. I think he's down like DC or something. So any type of menu can be done off the cart. It's all in the preparation and the loading and the menu building so that things, you know, flow from one thing to the next. As far as what you can do.
Jason, we need to bring this up. I don't know why my camera's doing wonky doodled on me.
It cut off the nose.
Yeah. Anyway, I see what's going on. But anyway, I've got you on the screen now, so I don't have to worry about it. Anyway, what I wanted to say is that if there are states, there are a lot of states that you can't do other things unless there's some unlesses, and we're going to go into that. But what there's things you can't do on the street. Jason is pointing out the things you can do. There's places like Washington State's pretty strict state, but we've got people with big dogs there. There's one in Tacoma that I know personally that is doing loaded baked potatoes from a big dog cart. Yep. He doesn't even sell the first. He's never sold a hot dog.
Yep.
Now, Jason, would you care, since I interrupted you, on the street food vending, is the other pet peeve you have, I know, is, hey, I got chili and I got leftover chili all the time. What do I do? Tell them what you do with that. The cross marketing, the cross uses of items, so that you have less items but more menu.
My go-to that I use all the time isn't the chili. It would be like the pulled pork, okay? Because obviously we know people do the exotic dog. So if you're making pulled pork or you're buying pork from another truck or a restaurant, so we have pork, it can go on my hot dog, right? So that's one specialty dog. It can go on top of nachos. So you take a $6 nacho, run it up to 9 or 10.
Right.
If you're doing mac and cheese, you can do it in a layered parfait. So you put the pork at the bottom, a little bit of the sauce of choice, mac, meat, sauce, build it up with a nice little cheese on top, a little tri-blend feather cut. Or we can do an actual pork sandwich. Or we could move that pork and run it into a taco menu, a burrito menu. So that one protein is several menu items for me and slides across different menu days, okay? I like my menus, as you guys know, I don't do the same thing all the time. We did like 15 different menus off the truck, from East Coast surf to taco, burrito, exotic sliders, exotic sausage. You know, we did the barbecue, we did the burger, we did the exotic burger. So all these different menus, but it has to be able to slide through the week. And the other reason I prefer that or like it is, if I go to Ben's event and Ben says, oh man, we just hired a hot dog guy. okay, no problem. My next response is, you got anybody doing barbecue? You got anybody doing tacos? You know, and I list the other things I can do. And Ben goes, wow, we don't have a burger guy. You can do burgers off that cart? Hell yeah. They're pre-cooked at the commissary. Bring them in pans and au jus. They drop on the steam table. I can throw them up on the sizzle queue on that grill. Or if I have a Cater Pro, I've got a nice actual flat top. I can throw the burger up there, melt the cheese, pop it on a roll. Number three boat with the burger here and the top of the roll on an angle with the lettuce and tomato up on it here and three pickle slices, a couple napkins underneath, and I hand it across. It looks like $1 million. So not only is it not a hot dog cart, it doesn't have to be pigeonholed in the menu because I can do all these different things off that one cart. So if Ben says no to hot dogs, you got anybody doing exotic sausage? You got anybody doing meatball parms?
Right.
You know, things that I can do off that cart. And who do you think Ben's going to call next time for his event? Because I was so easy to deal with and then break his balls and try and talk him into, I can do, you know, you can have two hot dog guys. I just let him know the other things I can do off this cart. And he brought me in and did this. So next time I get the phone call first. And he'll probably ask me, what do you want to do? What menu do you want to do? And then I'll fill in around you. So,
you know, I want to bring this up because you helped Alex a bunch when he was getting started with Frankenstein's dogs in North Carolina. And, you know, he was pigeonholed by the state. The state said only hot dogs and sausages, all pre-cooked. And then you told him, hey, ask about, toppings. What toppings can he have? Oh, you can have pulled pork. You can have mac and cheese. You can have, and they were given all these toppings that you could do from your cart. Now,
so that wasn't a pulled pork sandwich. That was my pork topping on the roll.
On a roll, right.
Just like when we sold bacon jam, I wasn't packaging bacon jam. That was a side of bacon jam, no hot dog.
But you want to keep in mind, listen, you may be not in Cabarrus County, North Carolina, and your inspector's letting you do pulled pork on top of your hot dogs and sausages, okay, or the mac and cheese dog or whatever. And then your buddy, okay, is over in Union County, North Carolina, and his inspector says, nope, 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 and nope. You don't, your buddy should not be calling you out, okay?
Oh.
And I'm speaking to the buddies out there that call them out and go, oh, well, my buddy John, he's in Vendors United, and he's allowed to do it in Cabarrus County. No, BS, don't do that. Don't ever throw anybody under the bus. It doesn't help you. It's not like your inspector's going to go, oh, he does? Well, I'll let you then.
I'll let you do it.
They don't do that. That's not how that works. So always remember to be... defend yourself. Don't bring up other vendors. Okay. If you, by bringing up other vendors, will not help your case at all. If you get that in your head, there's no reason to bring them up. You'll only hurt them. You know, Corey had a truck kicking butt. He was approved. He was doing great. He always got scores 98 or above. And then some moron who had a different inspector didn't let this moron do something or another that Corey was allowed to do, so both of them can't do it now. What a stupid plan. Carl Harmon says he does his first event, and it was great. Fell in love, got the wife to help. Wow, she's on board with me finally. Wow, yeah,
hey, yippity, yeah.
Yep, heck yeah, that's awesome. Listen, somebody said earlier, Robert Huto said, I'm afraid to buy a used hot dog cart. And look, I have a whole series for free at learnhotdogs.com. Just type in the word used cart or used, and it's going to pull up how a used cart will help you. It's not the end of the world. If you can't afford it yet, and that's the only thing stopping you, and you can go buy a $1,500 cart, I promise you, in 2 or 3 weeks, you'll be able to buy a new cart.
Yep.
Forget the mess up with the, well, I may have to fix the water heater or the pipes may leak. Hot dog carts aren't complex.
It's not rocket science.
No. And even if you don't know how to fix it, a plumber off Craigslist and that's basically it. They'll do gas and water, and that's all it is. Okay, gas and water.
Michael Woods could probably talk you through it.
Absolutely. We've got tons, and even our help section shows you how to fix stuff. Either way, you will be able, don't limit yourself by waiting, because what it does is in our heads goes, well, I'm going to wait, and then the baby needs diapers because they had diarrhea for 3 extra days and we weren't counting on those extra diapers, right? So you gotta plan through this, and I got off subject, but I just wanted you to know, never limit yourself by your situation. Go ahead and do your due diligence still, and follow my steps on getting a great deal on a used cart. I'm not going to be mad if you didn't buy a used cart, I don't sell used carts, but a new cart for me, because I'd much rather you sell you the second cart and you still be in business.
Well, again, like we've talked about on the show, you can get in at a cheaper budget, and then in a couple of weeks, buy that Stan King, buy that Cater Pro, buy that Big Dog. I mean,
right?
Why not let the business pay the additional and recoup your money, and then you could either keep that cart for catering or open up another location or sell it. Right? I mean,
well, let's go into the other stuff, Jason. What else? What else is a hot dog cart? You got catering, private events. Catering's my favorite. And tell them a story about Jason. I mean, Mr. Wood.
Michael Woods. Oh man. He's done some big jobs. There's been a few. I remember there was one you and who was it? Mark went down and helped him with.
Yeah, we had to bring another cart to help him. He got such a big catering gig.
Yeah. I mean, there's times that, you know, you need to run a turkey fryer in a big pot to keep the dogs going and have a runner back and forth to the cart. But catering off the cart is huge money, because anytime you're doing catering, you're charging more than your street pricing. Okay, because you're coming off the street and you're going to location, so it's convenience for them. You need time to prep the job, get there, set up, do the service for usually 2 to 2.5 hours, and then clean up and leave. So my big thing when I'm talking to the other vendors, you have to charge more for your catering. Catering is never done at street food pricing. Okay, and we always do a service fee, which can be drive time, setup, gratuity, but we don't call it a gratuity. We call it a service charge at 18%, because a lot of times you wind up getting tipped on top of that.
Right.
So catering is a huge way to go. And we've even taught some old dogs new tricks after 5 years.
Yeah, 5 years of, hey, Gary's got a question. I'm going to throw it up on the screen. It says in Utah, it's not a question really. He's making a point. In Utah, I was told by the health department that I'd have to have an enclosed trailer. Gary, I'm going to give you the simple and quick answer. Go to learnhotdogs.com/liar. Liar. I'm not calling you a liar. I'm calling them a liar, because that's not the code in Utah. We have an awesome vendor in Utah. You know who I'm talking about, Jenny. Holy moly. Now, she did get the runaround, but as soon as she read that and started asking for proof of these codes, these imaginary codes, they don't exist. Go have fun, Gary.
That's more a opinion of one inspector.
Right.
And if you ask three inspectors, you got three different opinions. In Jerry Maguire, when he said, show me the money, show me the code.
Show me the code. Rigo Garcia says, I sell Japanese style pancakes off my cart. I don't even know what that is, but that is freaking cool. I'd love to see a picture.
That sounds cool.
Rigo, email me at ben@learnhotdogs.com. I'd love to see it.
I'd like to know the name of the cart. Is it like, you know, Nomori Gato Mr. Roboto or something? I mean, you could have fun with that name.
He asked how much a price range, don't want to get ripped off. Here's the deal. I covered that also in the used cart stuff, how to get the best deal. The bottom line is, no matter if, let's say you bought a $2,000 cart, it's worth $4,000 brand new, and you ended up putting $3,000 in it because you just made every mistake in the book, you're in at $5,000. It's going to pay for itself either way.
Yeah.
And it doesn't matter. Ultimately, it doesn't matter. There's people out there spending $1.5 million to get a McDonald's franchise or a Subway or something.
Yep.
And you're going to spend $5,000 and make 122 this year. So why it's just not logically, it doesn't matter. You do want to make the best decisions you can so you don't spend the $5,000 and make some mistakes. But even if you did, not the end of the world. Don't kick yourself in the butt. Just move forward.
At least you're working. You're working for yourself. Right. And, you know, once you start doing that and seeing the money that can be made in working, say, like a 10:30 to 1:30, 5 days a week, maybe the occasional events. I mean, you don't even have to do events. You can work the street, or you could just, if you got a full-time job, you wind up doing events on the weekend. Well, you know, we have plenty of people that have come in that way. Up, you're headless again.
Jason will tell you all day long, if you have the money to buy a new cart, buy a new cart. Okay? Mm-hmm. It just skips. Why be a cart repair guy? But if you have to, then you have to. Yep. But don't let that limit you. Don't go, well, I'm going to wait 2 years. I have a plan. In 2 years, I'm going to buy a new cart. No.
2 years, you could be dead.
Buy you a piece of crap cart. I don't care if you buy you a table and burners, a triple burner and a steam pan. You can go to town with it. And I show you how. I've got free information on this. So, and step by step. So,
I mean, look at Natasha. I mean, she lost her job working in the bakery and, you know, talked with me and wound up at a gas station under a tent with, you know, basically sternos and chafing.
Yeah. She's chafing. Awesome.
And then went, you know, got a little money. Started going well, started doing some cookies and things. And now look at her.
She was doing catering. She's
doing pickup and drop off orders for lunch every day. She's doing school orders, you know, starting to look at like the college to get on college campuses. I mean, that's another person that went in the middle of COVID, lost her job and started this under a tent with chafing pans and sterno. And now she has a big dog loaded up to the hill. And she's doing catering and pickup lunches. She's using the Order Grub app. I mean, there you go. So if she can do it during COVID, what's your excuse? You know, the difference between an entrepreneur and a dreamer is they replace one day I will with, no, I'll do it now. Amen. Or I'd like to. No, I'll do it now. That's the difference. You know, just remember, the dream's free. It's the hustle that's going to cost you.
Right. So Tommy says, looking at pre-cooked burgers and now not sure whether flat top or grill would be best.
Flat top burgers.
Let me just say this, Jason. I know you have an opinion on this and it's a good opinion, but even if you don't have either, it's still doable. You can take them right out of the wet au jus and just wiggle them off and slap them on a bun. Just don't steam your buns because you just put a lot of moisture on them naturally. Go ahead, Jason. Which one? Grill?
Griddle? I'd rather have the griddle just because I can dome the burger and melt the cheese quicker. You know, you take them out of the au jus, throw it on the grill, slap the cheese on top, dome it, meaning put a lid over top of it to hold the steam in. It melts the cheese really quick and pop it on the roll and boom. It's a quick way to do it. If you only have the grill top, you know, like a traditional barbecue grill, that's fine too. You can still do the burgers. They come out of the au jus, they go on there. It might take a little bit longer to melt the cheese, but, you know, it's still doable. I mean, I just saw the other day Ken modified the lid of his griddle or his grill to go over the griddle.
Yeah.
Cut the edges of the box so it sits on the side of the sizzle queue. It's, you know, smart. Strictly just for melting cheese quicker.
When he's talking about a sizzle queue, all is a stainless steel plate real thick that goes over the grill. So
that's an option for these guys. Who was the guy that asked that question? I didn't see his name. Sorry.
Tommy Logan.
Yeah. So Tommy, that's an option. If you find a cart that has a grill, you can get the sizzle top for it from Ben or somebody and put that on it and boom, now you got a flat top.
Now you got a flat top, right? Okay. Or you can use, you know, if you're not doing gobs and gobs, and I've used cast iron on top of my griddle.
Okay. Yeah, well, you get the little square cast iron pans. I mean, I got one that's, I don't know, 5-6 inches by 5 or 6 inches, you know. And
don't go out and splurge. Don't go think you got to have, you know, 16 griddles on a cart. You don't. I promise you, a lot of vendors in VU are making more than these food trucks because food trucks have payments. They have a mortgage type payment.
Oh, yeah.
So, all right. So I want to talk about something else, Jason, real quick. Okay. And then I want to answer some questions. Then we'll go. Okay.
Okay.
And I want to talk about, you know, we talk a lot about marketing and how to market. Let me pull up just your camera. Okay. We talk a lot about marketing and how do you say to your crowd that comes up to the cart, they're already looking at a menu. They're looking at all this stuff, your signs, lemonade and all the stuff. Right. And then you got to tell them, oh, we cater. Oh, yep. We do this. Here's my rack card. Take it with you. Read it later. You know, that ends up in their floorboard probably in 30 minutes.
Oh, yeah.
So you got to think through everything, the possibilities, and what's new with technology and what VU members have been testing. We've been testing this for a while.
This is what we've been testing. This is called the Popple.
Right.
Okay? Pop information over. So you can see it's not real thick. It's about the size of a quarter, a little thinner. And the easiest way to describe it, or the best way I've heard it described, is an electronic business card. Okay. So we pop that on the back of the phone. I use the Popple app and I load the name of the business, address, phone, email, website, special landing page, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, PayPal, Venmo, Cash App. So ways to pay the truck. All these different things can get loaded on there. And then I scan that Popple and put it on the back of my phone. Well, now when Ben comes over to me, or I put it on the window of the truck or on the front of the cart with a sign, scan me, they hold the top of their phone right here. The information shows up right on the phone.
No app, no nothing.
The person that's popping your info does not need an app. You, the operator, if you will, or the owner of the Popple, you just download their app. There is no monthly fee. They do offer a higher service, but it's for like realtors and lawyers and stuff like that for the things that it does. For food truckers, we don't need it. It's a free app. So other than the cost of the Popple, which right now is about $19.95, and there's a rumor of a discount code for VU members. So for $19.95, you get one Popple. Now they have them like this. There's all these different colors and finishes. There's bracelets. There's keychains. They have a card coming out, like a, looks like a credit card that'll have the Popple in it. So once you do that, there is no additional fee. And we can have multiple Popples. So there could be one on Diz's phone, one on Mrs. Diz's phone, one on the truck, one on the trailer, and one on the cart. They all point to the same thing, right? So you could have a special page on there. You could have your schedule as a landing page off of your website and have it point to that so people know where you're at on what day. You could do menus for each day. But this is the newest form of communication for food trucks and food truckers to their people. Because I could be at the gym and not have my wallet, but what's everybody got? They all got their phone with them. Right. So with that on the back of my phone,
yep.
I always have a business card.
Now, can you have more than one of those, Jason? Could you have one out where your menu is? Could you have one on your phone, but also one on the outside of your cart so that as people come up?
You can put a sign up, scan me for information.
Could you send them anywhere?
Yeah, you can, any landing page, any website, phone number, email, address, name.
And guess what? You don't have to pay for any of that website crap. So Google gives away websites. WordPress gives away websites. They're free. Just create your own website. You don't have to buy a domain even, okay? You just create your website with their fancy software that makes it easy. With maybe you just want your catering list or what your locations are every week. And you can update.
How about your order grub page?
Yeah, to your order grub page.
Your order grub page. rumor is there's a guy in VU that knows a little bit about order grub.
Yeah, there is. I've heard of him. He's ugly as sin, but he does know about it.
Got a face for radio, but he's a good guy.
So what else? Is there anything else you want to share about Popple? The value of having that. It saves you signage, number one, but it also gives them something easy and quick.
It's easy and quick, and literally their phone. So if this was my phone or on the wall, they put the top of their phone here, and that quick it pops up. The information's there, and they can download it. They can save it, anything they want to do with it. So and again,
one-time cost, $20, less than $20. If you're in VU, get it even less. But
yeah, we got a 20% discount for VU members. So there's a lot of discounts in VU, from insurance to mafia memberships to things like that. I mean, there's all kinds of discounts for VU members.
But still, $20, they can have a popple.
Yep.
And they can help their business. And that'll help your business, whether you're doing kettle corn with my cottage food stuff.
Yep.
So if you don't know what that is, kitcheninincome.com, and you can start from your house, and you can use your popple there. So
oh, yeah.
there's so many things you can do with popple.
Should we give one or two of these away?
Yeah, let's do it.
How many you want to give away?
Whatever you want to do.
Well, you tell me. How do we want to do it?
I don't know how to do it. We've got some questions to answer, though.
All right, well, let's answer the questions, and then we'll do it. Then we'll do some giveaway.
Jamie Coyne says he's never done coffee. Now, Jamie is a VU member. He's an awesome VU member, and he's smart as hell. And he is like MacGyver at building stuff. Build his own kettle corn. Build his own monkey thing that stirs it.
Oh, the monkey paddle. Yeah, that's right.
The guy is good. Okay, so Jamie asks, it's a bumpkin crowd, good old boys at a livestock auction. What cup size and price do you recommend on coffee?
I'd use an 8 to 10. Charge $1.50, $2. I don't like dealing with change, so it's either gonna be $1 or $2. Knowing me, it'd be $2, possibly $3, depending who else is selling coffee. So,
but it's 8 to 10 ounces, you're saying?
About 8 to 10 ounces, because you want to leave them. You're filling it up with probably 6, because you want to leave some room for cream, sugar. Again, I put out the PC sugars. I'd have cream, in the jugs or the pour tops, and again, the cream's got to be on ice and that kind of thing. But yeah, you got to leave a little bit of room, so an 8 to 10 ounce cup.
All right, so Rage Gamer says, what's the best way to make connections with local stores in your area? Thinking about asking Walmart about vending in their parking lot. Wasn't sure if that's some that was oftentimes off limits. Some Walmarts have let vendors do it. I have a course on how to get any Walmart to let you do it, but it's a secret. All right. But some Walmarts, you just ask, and I'll show you how to ask for free. Okay. Go to learnhotdogs.com, type in the word locations, and Jason and I have done probably 200 videos on locations, trainings on locations.
We've done complete shows just on locations, just literally listing them.
Right. Literally listing how to get them and what to say, so that it makes them feel like they need to be paying you to do it.
Yeah.
Okay. And I'll show you in a three sentence deal what to say so that they feel like you'll have them do this. Well, how much is this going to cost me for you to be here? And it's all in our perception, right? So, keep that in mind, Rage Gamer. My inspector said no way here in Wake County to mac and cheese. This is Art Mac Daddy Dogs. Y'all seen Art's videos. I got a new video of his coming up probably Monday. My inspector said no way here in Wake County to mac and cheese or pulled pork, even as a topping. That's right, Art. And guess what Art didn't do? Art didn't go, Alex is able to do that over there in that other county in North Carolina, because Art's in North Carolina too. Never do that. Fight your own battles. Wiener Wagon, this is good stuff. I was just wondering today what all we could make from our cart. Wiener Wagon, you would not believe the people that have exploded their business in the last year, because Jason really started consulting vendors, mostly in VU only. He does some outside of VU, but it's rarer. He takes them first. They get first dibs. And he does consulting with vendors, and he'll take any kind of issue you have. Let's say you got two issues or three issues. You send them to him. He's going to make a call with you, and he's going to explode your business because you've got a professional there who's going to be able to tell you every single thing you must do and how to do it. And if you have any qualms with any of it, you just say, hey, no, I don't want to do that, or I'm not comfortable doing that. He'll tell you how to work around that. But he'll give you solutions so that when you get off the phone, you should end up like Terry did. Terry with 27 bajillion pages
20, of notes. 29 pages of notes. She was so excited. She was so excited. She got up at like 3:30 in the morning and started typing them out.
So you won't miss out. You can contact Jason and anytime you want. We can put his email here in the chat if you'd like it. I got to figure out how to do that. Apparently it's not going to let me do it yet. Yeah, it's not letting me do it. I'll figure it out. Anyway, it's beardedwarriormonk@gmail.com. And beardedwarriormonk@gmail.com.
Where that came from.
Yeah. You know what I'm going to do, Jason? I'm going to put it on the bottom and then
okay.
grab it. Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
And you spell warrior and then monk, M-O-N-K, right?
Mm-hmm.
@gmail.com. Okay. So
yeah, when this took over the trucks, I had to come up with a new email address.
Yeah, that was so long. Well, you only had 17 with that truck. So anyway, Jay, congratulations. He's waiting on the city. Wiener wagon's in the house. I bought a used one in great condition. Smart, smart, smart. Howdy William. Let's say I'm building a hot dog bar on a 4x8 trailer. Awesome. We've got vendors that are doing it, done it, and already successful with it, who built their own thing. So, and you can see that, in VU, vendorsunited.com, if you're interested. Jim Mull, let's see, Philip Purcell, my old butt figured out how to fix myself. Jays. Not sure what that is. I just don't understand.
Got me on that one.
Let's see. I'm doing 100% 2 ounce all beef hot dogs, 100% jumbo all beef, 100% Polish sausage, 100% all fully cooked, 1/4 pound and 1/3. That's from Ryan. I think Ryan's talking about 100%. Maybe he means by 100% markup.
No, it's probably. It came off the screen real
Did
quick.
You see that?
Probably. Doing 100% 2 ounce all beef. So he's probably just saying it's all beef, not a one of those, you know,
pecker. Not a chicken pecker and bacon wing.
Yeah.
All right.
Yep.
Ryan says he's buying a cash cart, financing it. Congratulations, Ryan. Hollis says, when do I get my interview, how to sell hot dogs without a cart? Hollis has can and will do about anything. The guy, it does not take no for an answer. There ain't nothing going to stand in Hollis's way, and he will show you. Hollis, we need to get together. Email me again or something, because I've slept since we last talked, and I do want to interview you. Sean says, good evening, Brian. Surf safe done. Brian Pierce says, surf safe done. Wife gave me the okay for the cart. Freaking congratulations.
There you go. Got permission from the boss. That always makes it easier.
Yep. Brian's in VU too.
Kind of hard to hide that, you know, when it shows up the house, you know.
Oh, the dog house is here. Hey, hot dog family, Gary Grant, where do I find the vendor in UT? Oh, Utah. I would like to get a dog in the area. You're going to have to look it up. I used to get
actually, she just moved.
Oh, she did. She's in Colorado.
She's in Colorado. Her husband got a transfer, and he's with like a big tire company or something, and they got transferred.
But she was over near Orem, I believe. But there's other vendors, and we've got vendors in VU that are in Utah.
Because I think she sold it to somebody that was working for her or something, but I'm not positive. So
there's always this. We used to keep a list of where all the vendors were, and we do in VU. But and here's what happened, Gary. Is people would show up to a vendor because they heard about it on here, and they'd show up to a vendor, and now they bombard them and take over their day. And so we created best day ever, learnhotdogs.com/best day. And you can go to one of the vendors that has said, hey, we don't mind the 80 bajillion questions. We'll let them stay there all day for no charge. And so it's a no-fee deal, and you can go do that. But as time went by, we had to get rid of the list. We had a lady in Arizona, Jason will remember this. Her name was Jackie. lived in Surprise, Arizona. I interviewed her live. She goes, yeah, give them my number. Give them everything. Put me on the list. And in one day, she got, I don't remember if it was 50 or 60 freaking calls, and she said, take me off the list. Take me off the list.
Yeah, it gets a little...
Because it was everybody not wanting to do their own due diligence. They wanted... Yep. They want basically wanted her to do it for them. Tell me where to go. Who do I talk to? What car should I buy? And so we quit all that.
Yeah.
I've been doing a birthday party with 50 people, 15 sausages, 50 hot dogs, a 2-pound pasta salad. What's a decent price? Go. Sean, I'll let Jason handle this, but I promise you we have covered this 7 ways to Sunday, and there's about 11 different variables to this question you're asking.
Well, first thing is, how far away is it? Second, are you supplying the drinks and chips? Third, have you given a price yet? Me, I do a per head price, and then I hit them with the service fee of 18%. But for me, that type of event with, let's just say you're doing a chip, a dog of choice, soda, and the pasta salad, right? You're serving all that. I'm going to be somewhere in the neighborhood of 11 to 14 on that. And if you need an idea for your area, what you can do is pick up the phone, call a local caterer and say, hey, I'm having a birthday party. What would you charge me for hot dogs, some sausage, pasta salad, soda, water, chip, and see what they say. And I think you'll be shocked what a caterer in your area charges for that same menu. Okay. Now the difference is, you're bringing in a whole different type of nostalgia with the street food, with the hot dog cart or the mobile food cart. Caterers going to show up and they're either working out of hot boxes or your kitchen, or some of them might have like a truck or trailer they work out of. Not the same as having that cart in front of the house or in the backyard next to the pool. Big difference. Okay. You need to charge for that. The other thing is, you need to remember, it needs to be done at not street food pricing. This is done at a premium.
It isn't that a discount.
Providing a service. So hope that covers.
What was it? What was it that Michael Wood, I know you'll remember this, said on Monday night about his catering and his pricing? Because he has always, for since he's been doing catering, he's always been cheaper than you would have been, obviously. But
oh God, yeah.
He also was. He didn't really give a discount in it, but he was about the same price. Now
he was kind of the same as his street pricing.
He changed it, and he said, "I won't now. I won't even go out there if it's 300 flat fee just for me to show up."
Yep. Yeah.
And he's in a little podunk town in Georgia.
Yeah. Well, I mean, not really even the sticks. It's more like the twigs.
Twigs, right?
Yeah. So that gives you guys an idea of what the population there is. You know. It's not a family tree. It's kind of a branch. So, and if he can be there and have minimums, you can anywhere else in the country too.
Well, I am
waiting on a cash cow. There you go.
Let's see. There, Tommy says he will do that. Slap a griddle on top of the grill. Smart. Thank you.
There you go.
Okay, let me go to, let's see. Quick question. I'm doing the numbers for hot dogs and I'm setting a goal. Is $250 profit per day too high or low? What do you think? Brian, it depends on where you are. There's so many variables there. Because, you know, like I did in the VU group recently, Brian, and I know you were there. We can talk about Jason making $4,000 in 3 hours. Or we can talk about Diz doing $1,500 in an hour. But is that it may not be realistic for you in the area you are, the location you are, or whatever, or until you get your menu honed in or whatever. So you don't want to be upset if you do $100 an hour. Because
I mean, are you making bottom line in your JOB? Are you making $100 an hour?
Right.
What would you make in your JOB in a full day? 8 hours, 6 hours, 10 hours. If you double that, would you be happy? If you tripled that, would you be happy? If you could work 10:30 in the morning till 1:30 and double what you take home from that JOB, working 5 days a week and being able to go see your kids' little league game, your daughter's dance recital, have dinner with the family. Is that good enough? I mean, for most people, it is. You're working for yourself at that point. You're making money. You're making connections, because as soon as you start vending on the street, you're going to get asked about catering. Now, you do have to educate the customer, but that's where things like that pop will come in, you know, and signage or rack cards, things like that. And you let people know, I do catering. Next thing you know, you're getting called for little leagues and track meets and, you know, parties, employee appreciation days, customer appreciation days, things like that. I mean, speaking of Michael Woods, he does Ford dealerships. He's there a couple times a month at the Ford dealer down there, to the point they have a gigantic mural painted on a wall in there, and it's got Michael in his hot dog cart.
Yep.
I mean, so he's basically part of the fabric of that town and painted into a mural. So, yeah. What was that? It was Brian, right? Yeah, Brian, $250 for a day. If you can clear $250 with your cost being about $70 or so, that's a great day.
Yeah, fantastic day. I didn't do that well in the beginning. Wiener Wagon, where can we get a Popple? I put it on the site, popl.com. No,
not .com. Not .co.
.co. Yep. .co. I put it at the bottom scrolling. Also,
if you're in VU, you get that 15% discount.
Yeah, or 20 or whatever it is. Where can we get Doghouse says hot dog catering company, $800. I don't know what that's in reference to, but I like the sound of $800.
If you can do $800 in the 2 hour, 2.5 hour service, that's a good day in my book.
Elias says you're my favorite YouTuber. Well, thank you, woo-hoo, Elias. That means you haven't seen a lot of YouTubers, okay? You have a very limited scope of YouTubers. Let's see. I'm not even my favorite YouTuber. we're going to give away some Popples, right?
Yeah, I'm thinking decide on how many you want to do, and how about they put it up in the comments. You know, the first
we
X
have
amount.
A lot already in the comments, but we'll have to redo it.
Let's clear it. Clear the comments.
Archie's Burgers wants to know where you can find a grease trap. If it's one of our carts, contact Keith at hotdogcartstore.com or service at hotdogcartstore.com, and you'll get Keith or one of the guys, and they'll help you. What is VU? Vendors United. Go to vendorsunited.com. I have a video there. You'll get to see my pretty face telling you what VU is. It's a group of vendors that help each other, and we share some insider stuff that would not benefit anyone if it was everywhere, because if it was, it would be used and abused and make it worthless.
We have a show on Monday nights. The show is 9 o'clock Eastern, usually an hour, maybe an hour and a half. There's the Facebook group. So there's, you know, always people to ask questions to, and there's guys like myself and Diz and Corey and Michael Wood and Keith and Mark that are always around to answer questions, whether it's on catering or, you know, different things. And it's continuing education. And it's a business deduction. So, you know, it's probably the best way I can describe it. Continuing education, amazing resource, because there's discounts in there. There's articles, there's Excel pages for download of different things, menu contract, catering contract, all these different things. I mean, just a lot of stuff. And is there still a free trial for VU?
Yeah, there's a free trial. You go to vendorsunited.com. It's free. It's a full open thing. So you'll have access to free courses that are sold elsewhere and all kinds of stuff. You'll get a lot of information. Plus, we don't hold anything back. So you're part of the group. You're in the Facebook
group. You can see the Monday night show.
Yeah, you can see the Monday night show. I want to answer one more question, then let's do this Popple.
All right, and then we'll have to ask him a question to get the Popple.
Till we say. All right.
Okay.
What is the average days per week you can vend, taking the weather into consideration in the Northeast?
Well, I mean, I vend right through the winter, from being in the cart or the truck. I mean, you know, I'm at the ski resort, so, you know,
Well, look at Lev Tov in Canada with a freaking Cater Pro, and Vin's in the winter.
Yeah, there's guys that were up in Alaska that vended. I mean, you know, obviously, I'd recommend a 10x10 tent with the three partition sides on it, and possibly, definitely like a stall mat from Tractor Supply or one of those places to stand on.
Yeah,
that's a huge difference in keeping yourself warm. Possibly a propane heater, but the tent setup is huge because it's a windbreak.
But William, to answer your question, we've got vendors in Michigan. It's an older couple. I've written a story. I've interviewed them. They're an older couple. They work on a boat in not Lake Michigan, but Michigan Lake. And they work on a pontoon boat. They now have two carts on the boat, two big dogs. And they take off the entire winter. So they're closed from September till about now, middle of April. And they closed. They make plenty of money the other months, and they don't work anymore. I actually believe it's May 15th they open back
up. They start.
I think it's May. Anyway, Popples.
All right, so the question you have to answer to get the Popple entry is, do penguins have knees?
Holy hell. All right,
so... I didn't even stump Ben for a minute.
Yeah, I'm still stumped. So I don't know if that means. All right. So, okay. John says no. Everybody says no. Nobody says yes.
How many are we giving away?
I don't know. What do you want to do? You, it was your freaking bright idea to give stuff away.
Let's do five.
All right.
We'll get mailed out tomorrow. If they follow the instructions, if you get chosen, once Ben says how we're going to do this, you need to email Ben at Vendors United, your name, your address, including your zip code, phone, everything, so I can get in touch with you if need be. And I'll mail those out.
Name, address, and phone number is best. You will not be put on any kind of mailing list or anything. All that's going to happen is I'm going to take the five winners. I'm going to send an email over to Jason. He's going to contact Popple, and they're going to send these out to you. Okay?
No, I'll mail these tomorrow. I actually have them here.
You're going to mail them.
Yeah. Okay. Yep, I'll mail them tomorrow. So I'll get the list from Ben, and I will mail them tomorrow. So probably 3-4 days. I send them out first class. So a couple days, you will have them in your hot little hands.
I didn't know you had extras. So
yeah. Yep.
Freaking awesome. Okay, so do you want me to just randomly pick people?
Whatever you want to do. You want to pick them, or you want to clear it and have the first five that type in?
We've cleared it three times now, and so...
let's clear five.
Let's clear it. All right. All right. So who's here? All right. Starting right now, right this second, who wants a Popple? And I'm going to just pick you at random, okay?
And I have random colors, so you're going to get what you get.
Richard Flair, okay? So remember that one, Richard Flair.
Oh, wait. They got to email you, because I'll never remember this.
No, I'm going to put the email.
Oh, all right, because I was going to say, that's a good thing about senility. I can forget about it, and I meet new people every day. So it was Ric Flair.
Woo! Yeah. Or Flar, or it's F-L-A-A-R, I think. Okay, so let's see. Bear with me. I moved it when I went over and had to put Ben at VendorsUnited.com.
Oh, now you did it.
Yeah, I'm getting there though. Jason Duncan.
Okay.
Jason Duncan, you're a winner.
All right, Jason, you need to take Ben's address down there, VendorsUnited.com. Send him name, address, and phone. Again, you won't get added to any kind of list. The five winners will be emailed to me tonight. I will then put these in envelopes and mail them out tomorrow.
Dorothy Robinson.
Okay, got it.
All right. I'm just flicking my fingers down it until it stops and wherever the mouse is.
It's very scientific.
John St. Sauveur, probably French. Saint Sauveur. John, you're a winner.
He could be Creole too, I guess, right? French Creole?
Probably. Did I how many do we have left? Two?
One.
Tammy Lynn.
Baker?
Just Tammy Lynn.
Okay.
Not Tammy Wynette. Not,
all right. Well, Tammy, you need to give a last name there in that email so I can mail that to you tomorrow.
We did four.
We did four. No, we did.
Flair.
Flair. Jason. Something ST.
Okay.
Then there was another woman's name, and then Tammy. That's five.
All right. We got them.
Yep.
Listen, Art, make peace, and he never won anything. BS. To be with us every Monday night, Art. All right.
Is that punishment or is that a win?
I don't. It's probably punishment because Michael's there and Keith's there. Anyway, I love you. Thank you for being here. Hope that you got something from this. Hope that you can see the value that you can get by not looking at it as just a hot dog cart.
Not just a hot dog cart. That is one way to piss me off when you talk to me. It is not a hot dog cart only. It is a money-making machine or a money-printing machine if you really want to get down to it.
All right. I'm going to give another one away. Mary Jo McAllister there. I was going to pick Art, but he started whining, and I was like.
So we got six?
Art. Yeah, we got six. Mary, what was it I said?
McAllister. Mary Jo McAllister.
Mary Jo McAllister.
All right, Mary, you need to.
She put her name in all five times. So.
Oh, wait, we just erased those. Sorry to those five. We're going to pick another five. Better luck next time.
Send me an email, folks. If you won, I should get six emails, and I will send those over. Jason will send those out tomorrow to you.
Yep.
If you need any help with setting it up, want to know how the best way to use it, join VU, even if it's free. Take the free and get your questions answered. See how the other vendors are using it. Now, I want to answer this real quick because somebody's already sent me a message here. No, we are not getting paid, reimbursed, recognized by Popple. We have zero to do with the company. Nothing to do with them.
To give you guys an idea, they offered us a kickback, and what we did was we asked that it be used as a discount to the VU members. Okay. Yep. Same thing with our insurance discount. We don't make any money. We're not monetized by them. This discount was basically what they were going to pay us to help put the product out there. We asked that the discount be given right to the members when they order. So they created a discount code for us off of VU, and they could order and you get the discount and it goes between you and them. These giveaways are, yes, I'm mailing a few because we bought some to give away. But if you buy them with the discount or whatever, it is right between you and Popple, not us.
All right. Dragonfly, I love you. Thank you for saying that. I love humanity and I love you. And
bologna sandwiches on the grill.
Yeah. Bologna and cheese sandwiches, tomato sandwiches, but in a different way. I can do without those. Can't do without you. I love you. I wish you well. I will be back. I will start doing these more frequently. I apologize. It has been hectic. COVID has screwed up everybody's head, and it also affected me. It's been a challenge, and to work out schedules and stuff. Jason's been trying to get me and Jason have been trying to get this done for 2 weeks. So yeah. Here we go.
We'll get some more out there.
All right. Love you. Bye.